Welcome to the family and friends who have traveled near and far to join us for this joyous occasion. It's wonderful to have all of you here as we celebrate our undergraduate, master's, and doctorate degree candidates. Congratulations to all. Throughout history, it's always young adults who have both the vision and the will to drive revolutionary change that improves the world. We only need to look at the past 50 years in this country for evidence. All our significant social and economic justice movements were fueled by young adults, often by students on university campuses, challenging the status quo. What is the special power young adults have to fuel revolutionary change? Having spent my entire professional life on university campuses, I think I can answer the question. When something worthy needs to happen, when change is required, even the most progressive and open-minded adult always thinks of limitations first. Their mind goes to why something cannot be done. But young adults are not so bound by prior experience of failure. They do not accept the simple, unsupported answer that something cannot be done. Young adults do not lead by limitations. This is their power. Over the past 11 years as Chancellor of the University, you have challenged me across a wide array of issues. Most recently, a couple of years ago, you questioned my plans for UMass Carbon Zero, our ambitious vision to make the campus entirely independent of fossil fuel. Massachusetts, as one of the most progressive states in the country, has committed to achieving a statewide carbon zero goal by 2050. So in support of the state's effort, I thought I was being bold by announcing that our campus-wide carbon zero goal would be 2040. But you challenged me by asking, why 2040? Why not 2025? I had the vague notion that 2025 was unrealistic. After all, our campus is 160 years old with 170 buildings, some of which were built 100 years ago. Though admittedly, I didn't actually have any facts to back up this belief. So I requested an engineering study to identify a realistic estimate of the earliest date the campus could become entirely independent of fossil fuel. Based on the research and data, it turns out while 2025 was in fact impossible, but UMass Carbon Zero, with the right support, we could meet our goal well before 2040, and in fact, we set up a 10-year time frame for that. Had you not challenged me, had you not used your student power, the university would have missed a critical opportunity to accelerate its vision for a fossil-free campus and being a leader in this field. This is the power of young adults. So very shortly, with the flip of your tassel, you will transition from being a student to being an alumnus of the University of Massachusetts Amherst. And well prepared with your university education, you will begin the next chapter of your life. In the years ahead, I ask that you hold on to your student power. Do not accept limitations unquestioningly. Never acquiesce to the easy, conventional wisdom. Continue to always distinguish between mere opinion and evidence-based argument. Hold on to your student power, because I know therein lies the hope for the future of our planet and a global community defined by social justice and opportunity for all. This morning, we celebrate your commencement, our annual reaffirmation that replenishes the soul of our campus. It is the moment when all the sacrifices and hardships are transformed into the power of an education. For more than 40 years, as a university professor and administrator, I have loved watching our students grow up, develop, and graduate. Your commencement is the last time I will stand on this platform and witness the transition from the student body to alumni. Being a part of your educational experience has been such a privilege. I cannot think of anything more inspiring and more fulfilling than empowering the future citizens and leaders to be global agents of change. Congratulations, class of 2023, and go UMass! Thanks. Thank you. Very kind. Thank you.